team for a look at what's next for our nation. Live coverage of the presidential inauguration tomorrow at 9 a.m., 8 central on CBSN.
Hi, everyone. Really good to see you again. I'm Anne-Marie Green, as per usual, alongside Vladimir Duthiers. A huge week, Vlad. We have one administration leaving, another administration beginning its tenure. And both administrations actually have been quite busy, sort of behind the scenes and in front of the cameras over the past few days. So we're going to bring everyone up to speed.
Yeah. It's interesting, Anne-Marie. It's sort of bittersweet because every 4 years, either if a president is reelected or there's a new president, I get excited because it's such a hallmark of our democracy and of our republic that we have this peaceful transfer of power every 4 years, or if a president, of course, is reelected in 8 years. And this time we're not able to really do that, although it's happening and it's taking place just as it always has. There are these restrictions. We've got National Guard troops on the ground in the Capitol. It's heavily fortified, although the images that we've started to see coming into us are very beautiful and breathtaking. So I wish we were there. Normally we'd be there covering it on the ground, but because of all of what has happened, we're not able to do that. So it's sort of, for me, kind of a bittersweet moment. But as you say, this country is gearing up for a new president. But first, we are going to begin on Capitol Hill, where the United States Senate will soon kick off a series of high-stakes confirmation hearings for President-elect Biden's top cabinet nominees. Lawmakers will question his picks to lead the State Department, Treasury, Pentagon, and Homeland Security, along with the Director of National Intelligence. However, there are growing concerns that Mr. Biden could take office tomorrow without any confirmed cabinet members. The Senate will have to juggle these confirmation hearings with President Trump's second impeachment trial. It remains unclear exactly when House Speaker Nancy Pelosi will deliver the single article to the upper chamber to begin that process. This all comes as President Trump wraps up his 4 years in office by gearing up to issue a long list of pardons and commutations. We're waiting to find out who will be directly affected by this, but a source tells CBS News the president is not expected to pardon himself. Meanwhile, more than 20,000 National Guard troops are pouring into our nation's capital to secure President-elect Biden's historic inauguration tomorrow. We will have full coverage of all these major headlines throughout the morning. But first, let's begin with Weijia Jiang in Wilmington, Delaware, where Mr. Biden is gearing up to take office.
CBS News got an inside look at the inaugural platform and the view from President-elect Biden's lectern, where he will deliver the most important speech of his career. Louisiana Congressman Cedric Richmond will serve as a top advisor in the West Wing.
I think he's going to share his vision for the country. He is the president for all of America, and he's going to govern that way.
To govern, Mr. Biden will need a team. Today, Senate confirmation hearings will start for five of his cabinet picks to lead the Departments of State, Treasury, Defense, and Homeland Security, along with the Director of National Intelligence. In her opening remarks obtained by CBS News, Secretary of Treasury nominee Janet Yellen will call for major financial actions now to prevent a long-term scarring of the economy later.
We're going into Wednesday knowing that we're ready to do the work.
The transition has been tense, with far less coordination than usual between the Trump and Biden teams. In yet another sign, last night, President Trump issued a proclamation that would lift COVID-related travel restrictions for much of Europe and Brazil, places where the virus is still spreading. The Biden administration quickly rejected the move. Mr. Biden's incoming press secretary tweeted, "The administration does not